I will always have everything I need. You give me a greenhouse to light in. You lead me by a clamp of pool of water. You restore my strength. You lead me on the right path to show that He is good. Even if I walk through a valley as dark as grave, I will not be afraid of any danger because you are with me. Your rod and staff comfort me. You prepare a meal for me in front of my enemies. You welcome me as a common guest. My cup is full and filled over. Your goodness and mercy will be with me all of my life, and I will live in your house for a long, long time.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Let's give a hurry to preach our song. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for another day.
Yes,
Lord. We want to thank you for a day that's never been seen before, that's never been seen again. You woke us up this morning. Help us in our right mind that we have seen, praise you, and enjoy. Father, we have to bless them and show you this family this morning. Let the family of them alive. Father, we want to have to bless each and every one that's here today. And all those that have to provide the people that could be here. Father, we want to have to bless the sick and sick. Bless those that have left us on these hospitals, those that are in their own beds. Father, we want to have to look at over all those that are in hospitals, Father, we want to have to bless each and every one that speaks out of your name. Father, we want to have to bless each and every one that says, Jesus Christ. We want to have to bless all the world. Let them know that you are God, that you are still on the throne. Father, we have to bless all the brothers and sisters. Let them know that your will be done. These things we have to be sons of this name.
Amen.
Amen.
The man found for the sponsor meeting. Sponsor reading is found in Mark, in the program, Mark 9, 23-27. Those of us, if you can say, Jesus, everything is possible for one who believes, congregation.
Immediately before his father's name, I do believe, help me overcome my unbelief.
When Jesus saw that a crowd was running to the scene, he rebuked the impure spirit, you deaf and mute spirit. He said, I command you, come out of him and never enter him again. Congregation.
The spirit is truth. The Lord is so much my soul that me say, me fear.
All but Jesus took him by the hand and
lifted him to his feet.
He proceeded and had brought out a blessing to the book and the readers of the word. Now you have the hand of the vision.
Not on tomorrow, you might be. Okay, God bless. Hold on, changes is coming.
Yeah.
sewer.
Can't just sing it, you gotta believe it. Amen. Amen.
Happy birthday to you.
he's still able to move around real good. He may have some aches and some pains, but he's still able to get around. And some people younger than him who can't get around as good as he can. Yeah. Well, they say, mind, he might forget a name or something every once in a while or what he was saying, but he day is still up there. Black, you know, happy birthday. We appreciate you. Hope you guys had a good time on y'all mini vacation. Hope you guys came back relaxed, feeling a little rejuvenated, a little peppy step. You got your car last week, so I don't got no car for you this week. And our other birthdays, we have two more birthdays for this month. One of them is in here, Sister Sean Jones. I hope that everything is all right with them.
Yeah.
And then we have Sister Johnny Cooper. Her birthday is coming up this month as well.
God don't stop for no one. Regardless of what we thank God for the doctor knowing time for to God. God is good. Oh, we put the time this weekend and everything. You have to go away sometime and take a break and rest your mind and your thoughts. And everything. But thank God we know that we're praying for us. We got them back and safe and everything.
Yeah.
It looks like my energy was drained now. When I come from the church, I don't know. But God has to wait.
That's it. Thank you.
God is my everything.
Yes, he is.
We got to change it up.
What's the difference between a service animal and an emotional support?
Oh, my everything.
everything. Yeah. Stop and try not using.
Yes.
Yeah, you know, we use it.
Everything.
We try yes, to do some things, but then we try to say we don't use it. We use it.
Yes,
let trouble come and see what you do.
Yes, sir.
Let finances get shut and see what you do.
Yes, Lord.
God is. He can outshout me, out talk me. I can deal with that. But yes, when we're praying, that's a different thing. And that's for anybody. When we're in prayer, we don't move around or walk. The urchins already know it. But urchins got there, you will feel. And sometimes they can't tell you. But please, if you see anybody, be ready to go with it. Wait to pray over there. But anyway, back to the story, God is. I'm so sorry.
If Jesus hadn't came around, if Jesus had
change. And then we say that, and ain't nothing but Jesus. Ain't nothing but God. Because I believe that's who changed me. Because I couldn't change myself after all these years. I done tried. But when I cried out, when I got on my knees, when I talked to him, yeah, he made a difference. I believe. Yeah. And the young man's father said, well, they tried, but they couldn't do nothing. The nine disciples asked, well, why we couldn't do that? Jesus said in the scripture, because you didn't have a faith. There's some things that we have faith in that Jesus will give us, and Jesus will do if we're walking right. If we're acting right, if we're serving the Lord. See, we think we're going to get everything we want, and we're not doing nothing for the Lord. We're not making that sacrifice, doing things, bringing people to the Lord, witnessing to people for the Lord, talking about the Lord. But the Bible says, ask what you need, want, and he gives you. It's that what you need, not the Lord. Not all you want. So you got to look at those things. What am I doing for the Lord, first of all? Am I obedient? Am I faithful? Am I talking to other people about it? I'm working for the Lord. I'm just going to church. And now, because I'm going to church, I can get what I want. Do what I want. Act the way what I want. And God going to be there for it. There's things that the Bible teaches you, we have to do. We have to become. We have to grow into. So we can believe and trust in the Lord. But the father ran up to him and asked him, well, could you help him? And Jesus said, do you believe? And the father said, I believe that you can heal him. I believe that you can make a drink for him. And he did. But when he did, and the spirit, all those evil spirits ran out of him, he laid there as if he was dead. You see the truth? It says he laid there like he was dead. They thought it was dead. I guess they wanted to laugh him, just like when Jesus told Lazarus to come out of the grave. Oh, he dead. But when the little girl, Jesus healed, she dead. But the Bible said he acted like a dead in the spirit. And what did he say? Jesus said, you know, took him by the hand, get up. Hey, you've been in a problem, a situation, or going through something that when you call out on the Lord and he say, get on. I gave you the answer. Get on. I made the difference that you're looking for. Get on. I am the way you make it. I am who they say I am. Do you believe? Do you believe in Jesus? Do you trust in Jesus? Do you know? Do you really believe in Jesus? Have you came and made a difference? Have you made a change when you thought it was all over with? And he said, that's all right. I got you. I'm taking care of this. Regardless of how they talk about you, how they laugh at you, how they look at you, I believe. Jesus, you got it. You make a difference. You make a change. Did you know what he had done for you? Do you know how he died on the cross and shed his blood and shrike that you might be healed? Have you opened the door where you can go to God for yourself? Do you know what he said when I'm living? How he took on things that didn't have, that he brought it where you can be firsthand in that, where you can have faith, where you can know him, know the Lord. Do you believe? Do you believe? Jesus has much love for you. God has much love for you, baby. Because he said, and then I said, He loved you so much that he sent his only begotten son down here to heal you, to help you. His son said, I didn't come down here to punish you or whoop you, but I came to save you. I came to heal. I came to change. I came to make a difference in your life. And in church, we are here to make a difference in other people's lives. We are here to uplift and help what we can do. We're here not to fight, but to adopt everybody into the family of God. And adopt everybody where they have peace, joy, and know who God is and what he will do and what Jesus has done. Do you believe that he wants you to work for him? He wants you to tell people? He wants to tell his story. He left his Bible to tell his story. Not just the, but his story. To tell what he, in the Old Testament up until the New Testament, what he's done and what he's going to do and what he's going to have done in your life. Can you feel it?
Yes.
Can you trust it?
Yes.
Do you know his spirit roaming around in here right today? We didn't invite his spirit in. And we call on him Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Can you see what he did?
Yes.
Pop out, feel, feel on the
right.
Like I say, when you come to church, you bring the problems, the situation, and when you leave out that door, you shouldn't worry about those problems, the situation, because Jesus got it. If you believe him, if you trust him, if you take time to listen to him, if you meditate on him when you're in church, when you're praying or talking about it, sometimes you got to meditate on the Lord. Let it work in your mind. Let it free you of the things that bother you. Let it take care of your aches and your pains. Sometimes you still have them, but you know, you're able to walk.
Amen.
There are some people got pains and aches and can't walk. There are some people got aches and pains and can't talk. There are some people got aches and pains and can't feed themselves. But God helped you through it. He helped you through it all. There are some people that get aches and pains by eating too many cupcakes. But God helped them through it. And they come back every first Sunday for their cupcakes. But God is good. God knows you'll be able to take care of you. How great he is. You realize Jesus has been there time after time for you. When the doctor say he ain't got no medicine for you. When your light bill couldn't be paid. When you run out of gas. When your wife or your husband or your fiance or your a specific color got mad at you about things happen. Did Jesus work it out?
Yes, it did.
Time after time. Well, did he dare to tell you, it'll be all right. I got this. When your social security check be late. And Jesus said, don't worry, it's in the middle. When you think you can't get back, can't get up. And Jesus said, come on up. Come on up. Come on up higher. Take another step. Do you believe it? Do you know it? Just in Jesus. And believe in him, he's calling your name. He's calling your name. He got something for you, if you believe. He got more than you ever thought you could have, if you trust him, if you believe him. He got your name. He got your name written in the book of life. He's just giving you time to get yourself shaken up and talk about him and tell others about him. Do you believe in Jesus? The doors of the church
open. Amen. Amen.
You can come by letter, Christian experience, or candidates for baptism. The doors of the church open.
Amen.
When you come, when you come, get to know him. Get to work with him. nothing he can't do. There's nothing he won't do. That's not in his order. He's not going to tell you wrong or how you're doing nothing wrong. Everything he does for a reason, and that goodness come out of it. They're blessing out of everything Jesus had you to do and wants you to do. You're doing what you're doing. Everybody come, so we're going to pull a couple of people going to our community. For I received from the Lord what I also pass on to you. But Lord Jesus on this night was betrayed, took bread, and was. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, this is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, this cup is a new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again. You ought to examine yourself, but you know, we talk about examining yourself, but we have to realize, sometimes we come in here mad, upset, or thinking something, and we just ask the Lord to come to us to forgive us. And the Lord will bless us. We don't have to say, I can't take this, I can't do that, but God is there. God is the one who can make us righteous and fix us up. Because like I tell people, if we could make ourselves righteous, we wouldn't need them. Right? If we're so righteous and we can do what we want to do, how would we even walk it? People holler, I'm not giving the church till I get myself right. You can't get yourself right. Mm-hmm. God can put you in a position where you don't want to be right. And once you accept Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ will put you in a good moment, a good place. So don't worry about the kick of all something. Being at the Lord's table for the things that he did for you. His body for your healing, the stripe for your healing. You gotta honor that. Know what he wants to do for us. We have old phobias why we shouldn't do this and shouldn't do that. But those old phobias right there on that cross, that beloved cross, when he died, when he took on and did these things for us, and we can't honor him because somebody else don't believe, but as a Christian, we need to honor him. We gotta think about what Jesus Christ did for us.
Thank you for thank you for the food and everybody that you gave to our food. Thank you for giving you death on these things that have been sent to us.
Amen.
Amen. everybody a chance to make sure they got everything ready. And he said, take this bread. This is my body. And lift it up, close it, and lift it up. Father God, we thank you for the community. We thank you for what your God is doing for us. We thank you for us, who you are and whom we are in you, Father. Help us to proclaim your word. Help us to help people believe and trust in you, Father. We need you. Let us get here from our home to where we're doing safe and sound and our job, Father. Let us be able to talk to somebody about you, Father. And let your spirit continue to dwell in us. We need you. We love you. In your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen. Amen.